cloudless sky, terror struck. To grasp the enormity of it is almost too much for the heart to bear. September 11th, 2001. It is a date that will be etched in history, engraved in stone, and in our memories. The day of the attack on America.
Something else just hit. A very large plane just flew directly over my building, and there's been another collision. Can you see it?
We just saw a plane circling the building.
Matt, I've never seen any. It looks like a movie. I saw a large plane, like a jet, going immediately headed directly into the World Trade Center. It just flew into it, into the other tower, coming from south to north. I watched the plane fly into the World Trade Center.
I just saw a second plane come in from the south and hit the south tower. Between the bottom and the top of the tower. It's got to be a terrorist attack. I can't tell you anything more than that. I saw the plane hit the building.
I was there, and I saw the building collapse. We all started running.
Freedom itself was attacked this morning by a faceless coward.
Where were you when the world stopped turning that September day? Out in the yard, your wife and children working on some stage in L.A. Did you stand there in shock at the sight of that black smoke rising against that blue sky? Did you shout out in anger and fear for your neighbor, or did you just sit down and cry? Did you weep for the children? They lost their dear loved ones. Pray for the ones who don't know. Did you rejoice for the people who walked from the rubble and sob for the ones left below? Did you burst out in pride for the red, white, and blue, the heroes who died just doing what they do? Did you look up to heaven for some kind of answer and look at yourself? What really matters? I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I can tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things he gave us, and the greatest is love.
Actually, at 9/11, on when the attacks happened, I was at TCC taking a science class, and I'd walked out of the science class, and everybody was gathered around the television, and one of the towers was obviously on fire. Kind of found out what was going on, and about that time the next plane hit, and about 5 minutes later they shut TCC down and said everybody go home. So on my way home I stopped and picked up my kids, and we watched the rest of the event at home, and couldn't really believe that what we were seeing on television was true, was real. It was really surreal.
I remember I was a teacher at Oliver Middle School, and I remember class, it was a normal day, and a teacher knocked on my door and just said, kind of almost in a panic, turn your TV on. And I remember that we watched the events of that day unfold right before our very eyes, and it was just an unbelievable experience. Somebody's already said surreal. It was means something that you couldn't hardly comprehend happening. Some of the things that I have remembrances of that day, one of the things I look at it every day in my classroom. This right here is a flag that my students made the year after 9/11. There were a lot of people that were doing remembrances, and I had a mother come in, and we learned how to crochet, and my students put this flag together. And I still see students often, and they remember putting this flag together. Another memory I have of 9/11 was my oldest son was 5 years old at the time. And when this happened, you saw the terrorist attacks all over the place. And I remember my five-year-old son, Zachary, he asked me, Dad, why did those bad men fly that plane into the building? And I still remember the feeling of, and the question of what answer am I going to give this five-year-old boy about a horrific event that even adults really couldn't put into words and answer, and which people are still trying to answer to this day?
For September 11th, I was actually teaching at Centennial Middle School here in Broken Arrow. And all I remember is our principal coming over and asking us to not be playing any of our TVs and radios. And that was it. And so, of course, we were all very curious of what was going on. On my plan, then, of course, I went to that and was shocked to see the events that are being occurring in New York at that time. And it wasn't until that evening that I really got the emotions of it and saw the devastation to the people that were occurring during that moment. It was a traumatic event. Having us already gone through our own experience in Oklahoma when the Oklahoma City bombing occurred to us, it was very real to see what those people were feeling like. And the fact that somebody could invade the United States and to do that much damage was very, very alarming and scary, since we are known to be one of the strongest nations. And so that's my main memory of 9/11.
During 9/11, I remember sitting in my classroom and we were doing work, and then all of a sudden there was like a principal over the intercom, and we kind of stopped everything. I don't remember what they said exactly, but our teacher turned on the TV and we sat there for a little while, and all we remember seeing is like a burning building, not exactly understanding what was going on. And it wasn't until I got home later that it was explained to me that airplanes had hit the Twin Towers, still not even knowing what the Twin Towers were yet. And then as I've gotten older, I've learned about it and realized how big of an impact it had on our world, not understanding at such a young age what it was yet. But now growing up, seeing and remembering that day when the Twin Towers were hit was such a big time. And I am lucky enough to remember it and have experienced it, but having those memories are also like a dreadful thing, because that was the day our whole world had changed.
I was in 7th or 8th grade at Oliver Middle School when September 11th happened, and I distinctly remember I was at Kevin Dewart's locker talking to him, and Debbie ran up and told us a plane flew into the World Trade Center. A plane took down two buildings. And I had no idea what the World Trade Center was. But I realized instantly that it was a really big deal. And within about 30 minutes, the entire school at Oliver changed. Everybody suddenly got really quiet. And you knew it was really scary because the teachers stopped talking. You would walk into a classroom and they just looked shocked. And they almost were so overwhelmed that they couldn't communicate what was happening. And our school instantly went into a information lockdown. Our parents could call and take us out of school, but we weren't allowed to watch the news unless we were in history class. And nobody knew it was happening, so everybody just started to silently panic. And then I finally got into my history class, Mr. Rogers' room, and he had the TV on, but he wasn't talking at all. And he just sat at his desk, and I sat and watched the loop of the plane hitting the building over and over and over again, and slowly started to realize that something absolutely disastrous had just happened.
September 11th, 2001. 11th grade. Broken Arrow High School, going between first hour and second hour. I don't remember what first hour was, but second hour, Mr. Miser's creative writing class with my best friend Addie at the time. She came up to me in the hallway. She said the tower had been hit. Mr. Miser turned the TV on, and as we took a test over the reading we did, we watched the towers fall. And then I wrote a poem. And that's all I could do with what I felt that day. And the memories come back every year.
On 9/11, I remember that I saw before I went to work that that one of the towers had been hit. I took a shower, thinking that it was just an error, plane accidentally off route. When I got out of the shower, another one had been hit. Then I pretty much knew. Eventually, I went to work. I was working at the church at the time, and we prayed, had the church open for people to come, just pretty much sat in disbelief the remainder of that day as to what had happened and what was happening in our country.
Where were you when the world stopped turning that September day? Teaching a class full of innocent children, driving down some cold interstate. Did you feel guilty 'cause you're a survivor? In a crowded room, did you feel alone? Did you call up your mother and tell her you love her? Did you dust off that Bible at home? Did you open your eyes, hope it never happened? Close your eyes and not go to sleep. Did you notice the sunset the first time in ages? Speak to some stranger on the street. Did you lay down at night and think of tomorrow? Go out and buy you a gun. Did you turn off that violent old movie you're watching and turn on I Love Lucy reruns? Did you go to a church and hold hands with some stranger? Stand in line and give your own blood. Did you just stay home and cling tight to your family? Thank God you had somebody to love. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I can tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things he gave us, and the greatest is love. I'm just a singer of simple songs. I'm not a real political man. I watch CNN, but I'm not sure I could tell you the difference in Iraq and Iran. But I know Jesus and I talk to God, and I remember this from when I was young. Faith, hope, and love are some good things he gave us, and the greatest is love. The greatest is love. The greatest is love. Where were you when the world stopped turning that September day?